Welcome to another interesting video on Automovie Channel. Today we are going to talk about the Automovie top 10 luxurious off-road SUVs in the world. Some SUVs are only meant on road only, and some are off-roaders which give the driver to drive on any terrain and turn around the world wherever they want to without getting stuck. Nothing can be like being in a luxurious off-road SUVs for assistance of drivers, whatever the terrain. I calculated this based on the performance and off-road reliability given by the SUV, based on their off-road features and their appearance, such as the approach angle, brake cover angle, departure angle, ground clearance, and wheeling depth. I also estimated them based on how fast they are on road and how balanced composed they are on road, and not only on off-road terrain only, because you can't be driving a vehicle on off-road all the day of your life, so they have to be a great vehicle on road too. So sit tight and enjoy the Automovie top 10 luxurious off-road SUVs in the world. On the Automovie 10th list, we have the Nissan Patrol. And back in 2000, it was originally designed for off-roading with big tires. As the year passes, the ruggedness looks reduced, but its off-roading incapability is reduced. There is no doubt that the Nissan Patrol is the successor of the great Nissan Armada. Now come to even think of it, Nissan Patrol has a 273mm of ground clearance, an approach angle of 34.4 degrees, which is very wide for an SUV, and a departure angle of 26.3 degrees. Wow, great Nissan. As a tough Nissan SUV, the Nissan Patrol can wade through a water of 700mm deep, which is even more than some of the SUVs compared to the Range Rover Evoque and the Land Rover Discovery Sport, which has a wading depth of 600mm. Which nothing will stand in its way. Along with that, the 2020 Nissan Patrol, with its previous generation, comes with a rear locking differential, which distributes torque evenly to the rear wheels, which makes you free from the sand, because the rear locking differential prevents too much spinning. And the all-new Nissan Patrol comes with multi-terrain select, which gives the driver ability to select if they want to go on rock, sand, snow, or mud. You can select any off-road program you want. The Nissan Patrol also has a variable 4x4 mode, which you can switch to low or high, or even switch to 2 wheel mode. Don't be also surprised for the Nissan Patrol comes with the limited slip differential, which allows the driver to maintain momentum even on slippery roads, and it prevents wheel from spinning too much. That means it gives the driver great control and comfort. The Nissan Patrol has a 6.0-liter V8 engine, producing 298 horsepower and 560 Nm of torque. It has a 7-speed automatic gearbox, which drives the 4-wheel, and it's a great accelerating vehicle, which does 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 7.4 seconds, which is very fast for an SUV like it. Lastly, talking about its price, it's available in two trims. The TI trim costs $77,000, and the TIL trim costs $93,000. On our night list is the Toyota Land Cruiser Prado. Since when the Toyota Prado has been brought to the market, the Toyota decided not to mess with it. It still retains its other brother capability, which happens to be the Toyota Land Cruiser. The Toyota Land Cruiser Prado has an intelligent 4-wheel drive system with a low-range transfer case to overcome any obstacle. It also has a torque-sensing and lockable center differential. And now, it also gets a new lockable rear differential. Wow! What an upgrade from Toyota. The Toyota Prado now comes with a new terrain response style of off-road traction and stability control, and also over multi-terrain select. Come to think of it, To that Lancashire Paddle has a 215 of ground clearance, 215 mm of ground clearance to edge over big hill and rocks. It has a 700 mm of bedding depth, which is same as the Nissan Patrol, and a 31 degree of approach angle. Wow, that is enough for an SUV like this. Funny enough, the Toyota Land Cruiser Prado now comes with a self-leveling air suspension standard, which lowers and higher the vehicle's height. Even on road, it gives it more composure and agility. And on road, the air suspension helps to soak bumps and improve comfort. The Toyota Land Cruiser Prado also comes with crawl control system, which gives comfort to the driver when off-roading. This system automatically moves and accelerates the vehicle without the driver matching the accelerator with the foot. Its acceleration speed and movement can be controlled by the driver through a switch in the infotainment. All the driver needs to do is just to steer the steering while off-roading. He doesn't need to worry about speed. The system will take care of the remaining. The car is suspended by a double wishbone up front and rigid axle, secured by four links on each side of the rear. The Toyota Land Cruiser Prado has a 5.7-liter V6 engine with 381 horsepower and 401 pound-feet of torque. It accelerates from 0 to 60 in just 6.8 seconds. On our hit list is the Toyota 4Runner, which comes with a 4.0-liter V6 engine with 270 horsepower and 278 pound-feet of torque. It has a 5-speed automatic transmission. The Toyota 4Runner accelerates from 0 to 60 in just 7.3 seconds. The Toyota 4Runner has an approach angle of 33 degrees, 26 degrees of departure angle, 19.8 degrees of breakover angle. It has a ladder, it is based on the ladder chassis, and a wheel depth of 27.6 inches. It has a full four-wheel drive system with active traction control, with an e-start assist control. It also has a multi-terrain select, crawl control, center and rear locking electronic differential. It's priced at £36,000 for the SRS trim and $45,000 for the TLD Pro. The crawl control system just makes things easier for the driver. The driver just activates the crawl control and just leaves the vehicle to automatically accelerate itself. The crawl control system speed can be selected from the driver's button side. The crawl control accelerates the vehicle automatically, in which the driver just steers the vehicle only, which gives the driver comfort and confidence on road. Thank you. seventh place is the Range Rover Sport SVR, which is one of the fastest SUV in the world, completing 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 4.3 seconds. It comes with a 575 horsepower and 700 Nm of torque with intelligent all-wheel drive system. It comes with Land Rover off-road programs such as mud ruts, snow, gravel, rock, and an auto select, which automatically selects the vehicle to the best terrain according to where the vehicle is and what the vehicle is passing through. The Range Rover Sport SVR has an ESC control, which lowers the speed of the vehicle to the lowest speed ratio on the gear when coming off a hill. It also has a steering response 2 system, which prevents the wheel from spinning. It has a twin speed transfer case, which provides a choice of high and low gear ratio. The Range Rover Sport SVR comes with an air suspension as standard, which lowers and increases the vehicle to the highest order and increases the height of the vehicle. The Range Rover SVR also comes with a low range mode, and also it comes with a center locking differential and a rear locking differential. The Range Rover SVR comes with a wheeling depth of 850 mm, which is deep for an SUV. Apart from off-road, the Range Rover Sport SVR is a very fantastic SUV to drive on-road. With air suspension soak pumps, which allows it to manipulate and improves comfort and agility. Though it's a kind of luxurious SUV in tone, but it's not as luxurious as a villa. Its price starts at $115,000. On our 6th list, we have the Range Rover Velar, which has a 5.0-litre supercharged engine with 550 horsepower and 680 Nm of torque. The Range Rover Velar accelerates from 0 to 60 in 4.3 seconds, which is similar as Range Rover Sport SVR. It has all-terrain progressive control, which is a system that automatically accelerates the vehicle in a low speed to allow the driver to only steer the vehicle. The Range Rover Velar has a wheeling depth of 650 mm. The Range Rover Velar has a center locking differential and a rear locking differential too, and also Land Rover off-road program such as snow mode, mud ruts, gravel, stuff like that. It also comes with hill descent control, which allows the driver to come down easily when coming off a slope. The Range Rover Velar also comes with air suspension as standard, which improves comfort and agility also because it adaptive drive dampers, and it's a very nice vehicle to drive on road. Its price starts at around $60,000 to around $77,000. What makes the Range Rover Velar an interesting luxurious SUV to drive around is because the driver can see through the infotainment touchscreen how the wheels are going and how the wheels is sending power to the wheels, how the traction control system is taking place, and how the percent of torque is sent to the wheels. The driver can see everything in 40 minutes screen, and how the rear locking and center differential are actually working. They can be shown via the touch screen. And it also has a weight sensor. This has a weight sensor by the door side, so the driver can see the depth of where the water is via the infotainment. Kirin Jova SUV autobiography also comes with the same off-road capabilities such as the Vela and the Range Rover Sport SVR. But what makes it better off-roader is because it has more wheeling depth, which is about 900mm compared to 850 of the SVR and 650 of the Vela. It also comes with all-terrain progressive control, which automatically accelerates the vehicle. It's also a very nice SUV to drive. It also comes with the higher breakover, departure, approach, angle too. The Land Rover Discovery has a 3.0-liter supercharged V6 with 340 horsepower and 4,000 feet of torque. It does 0 to 60 in just 6.9 seconds. And I'm happy to tell you that the Land Rover Discovery is the best off-roading of the Discovery family, better than the Discovery Sport. It has a 30-degree approach angle, 40-degree departure angle. It also has a 31-degree breakover angle and a wheeling depth of 900mm deep, which is much for an SUV, which means no water can stand its way. It costs around £45,000 to £62,000 for the HSE Dynamic. We'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And just like the Vela and the SVR, the infotainment touchscreen displays the information about the off-roading of the vehicle, where the center and locking differential are working, traction control system is taking place, and how the vehicle is off-roading, how the wheels are spinning, displays everything via the touchscreen. It also has a water wheeling sensor, which displays via the touchscreen so the driver will know if it's still wading within the millimeter or if it's going above the 900 millimeter, so that you'll be assured with safety. Fighting to create a song, I don't wanna miss a beat. And we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And the new 2020 Land Rover Discovery now rides on a leather chassis and an aluminium light frame. It has a wheeling depth of also 900mm deep, which is similar to the Discovery. It has a clear sight ground view system, which makes the driver to see underneath the skin, underneath the car to know what's going on, to see rocks, to know where the wheels are and how it's working. It also has a rear view camera, which displays via the mirror at the front. The Land Rover Defender has a 291mm of ground clearance, 30-degree of approach angle, 40-degree of departure angle, 28-degree of breakover angle, and 900mm of wheeling depth. Coming to its engine, that is 2.0-liter turbocharged inline-four gas engine with 296 horsepower and 295 pound-feet of torque. It has an 8-speed ZF automatic transmission, which does 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 7.7 seconds, which is quick for a rugged SUV and tough off-roader like this. It costs from £50,000 to £80,000. I mean, it costs from $50,000 to $80,000. I'm going to tell you that this is the best Land Rover ever capable vehicle, which can challenge the Jeep Wrangler Rubicon. It also comes with the center and rear look in the French house, and also comes with Land Rover off-road programs such as mud roads, snow, rock crawl, and so many off-road mode like that. It also has an intelligent four-wheel drive system with traction control. Mercedes-Benz AMG GT3 is known as a tough off-roader, which has a 4.0-liter bi-turbo engine producing 595 horsepower and 850 Nm of torque. It does 0 to 60 in 4.8 seconds. It has a 9G Trotonic automatic transmission. It has a ladder frame chassis with 3 low percent lockable differentials. It has 100% lockable differentials and a low range off-road gear reduction. It also has a new independent suspension with a double wishbone front axle and a rigid rear axle. It has 10.6 inches of ground clearance and a 27.6 inches of riding depth. It has 26 degrees of breakover angle and 30 degrees of departure angle. It also has 31 degrees of approach angle, and it costs around $150,000.
In the sky, gazing far into the night, I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light. We'll be right back.
Pranga Lubicon has 2.0 liter V6 engine, and there's also an optional 3.6 liter V6, which comes with 285 horsepower and 261 pound-feet of torque. It does 0 to 60 in 7.5 seconds, which is far fast considering how tough and how it can off-road. It has an approach angle of 44 degrees. It has a breakover angle of 27.8 degrees. It has a departure angle of 37 degrees and a 10.9 inches of ground clearance, which is actually long. The Jeep Wrangler becomes now comes with an advanced traction control system and a true torque electronic locking differential. It also comes with an electronic front sway bar disconnect with a 4x4 system. It has a center locking differential and a rear electronic locking differential. It comes with all-terrain tires, which improves grips. The main feature that makes this the best off-road SUV in the world, which makes it better than the G-Wagon, is because of its wheel articulation, which means it to climb anything without it spinning at all. This car costs around $50,000 compared to the G63, which costs around $150,000. Compared to how this thing can off-road and its performance on road, I feel this is the best off-road SUV in the world. So let me know in the comment section below if you agree with my verdict. But if you don't, let me know in the comment section below which SUV you think is the best off-roader in the world. Thank you very much. See you later. Also, if you just feel I didn't include any of the tough off-road that day, just let me know in the comment section which SUV do you think is supposed to be the idea input. Feel free and put it there. In my next video, it will definitely be there. Bye. Alright friends, thanks for watching. So those are the auto movie top 10 luxurious offroaders in the world. So what do you think about this video? Let me know in the comment section below. And also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so that you won't miss any of my wonderful uploads like this. I'm sorry for my voice. I don't really have a good voice, but I hope my friends you help me manage it. So take care. See you guys later. Bye. Don't also forget to tell me in the comment section which of these 10 do you think is the best. Let us know together. Let us know the best 10. And just pick one of the 10. Which one do you think is the best? Let me know in the comment section.